This weather has been awesome, and many of you are heading outdoors to enjoy it. But some unpleasant things come along with all that fun. All new at 6, Fox 2 meteorologist Jamie Travers spoke with some experts about what to do about ticks.
Ticks are arachnids, actually part of the spider family, and while they can be very small in size, the impacts that they can have on our health can be large. And with this warmer weather, they are really starting to come out.
You know, what we find is that when the phone rings early, it usually indicates that we're going to have a real tough year, and it's already started happening. We're anticipating a bunker year.
As your pets and kids play outside, be aware of the areas where grass is tall, wear long sleeves, and inspect yourself regularly. Also, use repellents.
We usually recommend something around a 25% DEET, so the offs, the deep wood offs.
And be aware of seed ticks. In the fall, adult ticks lay eggs in the foliage. When the weather starts turning, they start developing.
And a lot of times you think about, you know, they lay thousands of eggs at a time, so they're all concentrated. And if your dog runs through them, potentially you've got a couple hundred to a thousand of these seed ticks, if you will, grabbing on looking for their first meal. That's the sole goal in their life, is at that point of their life cycle, is to gain a blood meal, which is how they develop.
The Missouri Department of Conservation just launched a study that has never been done before in the state of Missouri. They're asking for our help with their citizen science project.
We don't have a comprehensive map of where all the tick species occur, much less the disease-causing agents.
This study is important because Missouri is considered a gap state in information by the CDC.
They recently did a nationwide look at where tick species were known from, and less than half the counties in the Missouri have any verifiable tick information at all. And so we just want to fill in the map of every county in the state to know which ticks are there. That's very helpful in knowing what diseases you might encounter there.
This will also help doctors.
We hope that increases the ability of the Department of Health and Senior Services to get information to physicians on diagnosing tick diseases properly.
So while you're outdoors recreating, if you happen to find a tick on yourself or on your pet, they ask that you send it into the A.T. Still University Lab in Kirksville, and I will have a link with all the information on that study and the directions on how to do that with this story online and on our news app. Reporting to Maryland Heights, I'm meteorologist Jamie Travers.